Welcome to our new video. My name is Michael Kögi, and in the next few minutes, I will introduce a way to assess the risk of particles on electronic assemblies. Particles on an electronic assembly surface can impair the functionality of the assembly and therefore also the functionality of the final product. Sources of particles can be found along the whole supply chain. Examples are production processes like screwing, supplied parts like bare boards, environmental influences like dirty air, or people bringing in particles like hair or skin. Consequences of those particles can be short circuits and, in the worst case, a thermal incident, electrical isolation of contacts, insufficient sealing of housings, disturbance of high-frequency signals, or interference with optical sensors or camera chips. But how can we assess if some of the before-mentioned consequences will occur? At first, we have to know which kind of particles are present on our assembly surface. Therefore, it is necessary to extract the particles from the assembly. This is an example of a possible workstation for particle extraction. The particles are removed from the assembly and collected in the extraction liquid. In order to remove the particles from the liquid, it has to be filtrated. Particles are optically detected and evaluated by microscopes, or like in this case, a flatbed scanner with the corresponding software. Now we know the number and size of the particles. Further analyses like SEM-EDS can help to identify their material composition. Even if determined metallic, we still do not know if they will have an impact on the functionality of the assembly. To find out more about the risk for short circuits, a way can be to measure the breakdown voltage for each type of particle. In this case, we apply typical application voltages from 3 to 24 volts to three types of metallic particles commonly found on electronic assemblies. These are copper, aluminium, and aged aluminium. The chart shows the different behavior of each particle material. Copper reacts at 5 volts, aluminium at 9 volts, and aged aluminium at 15 volts. Analyzing the breakdown voltage would also be possible with the filtration residue. So what did we learn in the last few minutes? The production process of electronic assemblies is full of particle sources. To measure the risk for short circuits or other consequences related to particles, we first have to extract them from the assembly surface. Afterwards, we can analyze their behavior under different voltages to assess the risk for a short circuit. In this case, the risk implied by the particles depends mainly on critical areas with high operating voltages as well as on the particle material. Concluding this video, I hope that you got some valuable insight on the risk assessment of particles. If you have any questions about the topic or need advice, you can contact us via the email address showing up at the end of the video. For more videos about reliability of electronic assemblies, please visit our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching and goodbye.